Hey there, my name's James, and I'm going to explain how the weighted average cost method works in four simple steps. So, the weighted average cost method. It's a bit of a mouthful, which is why sometimes you might hear it shortened to WAVCO, or the average cost method, or just plain AVCO. That's the one I like. It can all seem a bit confusing, but just remember that all of these terms mean the same thing. They describe an inventory cost flow assumption. What does that mean? How does that work? Let's find out. It all comes down to the inventory calculation. Your opening inventory plus your additions gives you your cost of goods available for sale. And when you take away your cost of goods sold from it, you get your closing inventory. Remember, when I say inventory, I mean the goods held by your business that you intend to sell to earn revenue. The thing is, when you make a sale, you don't only earn revenue, you also incur a cost. And inventory cost flow assumptions help you estimate what that cost should be. There are three inventory cost flow assumptions: FIFO, LIFO, and AVCO. First in, first out, last in, first out, and the average cost or weighted average cost method. When you make a sale using AVCO, you assume that all of your goods available for sale are valued at their weighted average cost per unit. It doesn't matter what order you bought your inventory, you assume that it all gets mixed up together, whether or not that's the case in reality. Remember, this is an assumption. You can work out your weighted average cost per unit by taking your total cost of goods available for sale and dividing it by your quantity of goods available for sale. Don't worry, we'll come back to this equation soon, but first, I'd like to give it some context. Let's imagine that you work in wholesale in the window cleaning industry, buying and selling squidgies. It's the beginning of November and you have an opening inventory of 220 squidgies, which each cost you $2 per unit. On November 5th, you go and buy another 400 more squidgies for $1,200 in total. And on November 12th, you manage to sell 500 squidgies for $2,750. The question is, what's your cost of goods sold and closing inventory for November, assuming that you're using the weighted average cost method to value your inventory? It's time for that four-step process. Step one, draw an inventory cost flow table. What's that? It's a table with five columns: date, description, quantity, cost per unit, and total cost. Step two, enter what you know. Okay. Well, we know that you start in November with 220 squidgies, which cost you $2 each. So at the start of November, you had an opening inventory of 220 units, which cost you $2 per unit. A few days later, on November 5th, you purchased another 400 squidgies for a total cost of $1,200. We'll need to pop this in the table too. On November 5th, you made additions of 400 units, which cost you a total of $1,200. In inventory cost flow tables, it's important to leave a blank row under each addition or sale. This gives you some space to calculate your goods available for sale. Finally, on November 12th, you sold 500 squidgies and earned $2,750 in revenue. Now be careful here. This is the revenue that you've earned, not the cost of goods sold that you incurred. So this doesn't have a place in the inventory cost flow table. That means on November 12th, you sold 500 units, but we don't know your total cost of goods sold yet. We'll work this out along with your closing inventory on November 30th. Time for step three, fill in the blanks. We'll start by working out the total cost of your opening inventory. You began the month with 220 units, which cost you $2 per unit. 220 multiplied by $2 is $440. Next, we need to find the cost per unit of your additions. You bought 400 units, which cost you $1,200 in total. $1,200 divided by 400 units is $3 per unit. To work out your goods available for sale, we'll need to take some subtotals. 220 plus 400 is 620 units available for sale, and 440 plus 1,200 is $1,640, your total cost of goods available for sale. Okay, here's where the AVCO equation comes in. We need to work out the weighted average cost per unit of your goods available for sale. This is your total cost of goods available for sale divided by your quantity of goods available for sale. Right, so your total cost of goods available for sale is $1,640 and your quantity of goods available for sale is 620 units. 1,640 divided by 620 is 2.6451619. But we'll round this to $2.65 per unit. $2.65, the weighted average cost per unit of your goods available for sale. All right, keep this number in mind for the next bit. We'll be using it to work out your total cost of goods sold. Your total cost of goods sold is your quantity of goods sold multiplied by the weighted average cost per unit of goods sold. We already know that you sold 500 units, but what's your weighted average cost per unit of goods sold? It's exactly the same as the weighted average cost per unit of your goods available for sale, $2.65 per unit. So 500 units multiplied by $2.65 is $1,325, your total cost of goods sold. Right, now let's jump forward to the end of the month and work out your closing inventory on November 30th. How many units of inventory do you have left over? Well, 620 minus 500 gives you 120 units. And the total cost of your closing inventory is 1,640 minus 1,325, which is $315 of inventory on hand kept in your balance sheet. Remember, we rounded your cost per unit earlier on, so this is an estimate. Step 4. Calculate your total cost of goods sold and your closing inventory. Your total cost of goods sold for the month can be calculated by adding up your cost of goods sold for every sale that you've made. In this problem, there was only one sale, so your total cost of goods sold for November is $1,325. And you can find the total cost of your closing inventory down here in the bottom right corner, $315. Okay, now I'd like to show you something interesting. This inventory cost flow table mirrors the inventory calculation that we had up at the start of the video. Neat, hey? But what are the implications of using the weighted average cost method? AVCO matches your current revenues against your average cost of goods. It's like the middle ground between the first in, first out and last in, first out methods. What do I mean by that? Well, FIFO matches your current revenues against your older cost of goods, whereas LIFO matches your current revenues against your most recent cost of goods. AVCO falls somewhere in the middle. It uses a weighted average. So for example, during times of inflation where cost prices are rising, your cost of goods sold under LIFO tend to come out the highest because it reflects your most recent purchases. And your cost of goods sold under FIFO would come out the lowest, because this assumes that you're selling off your older, cheaper inventory first. With the average cost method, your results come out somewhere in the middle. If you'd like to see how I calculated these results using FIFO or LIFO, then you can find the videos in the inventory playlist over here. I've summarized all four steps that we just went through in my cheat sheet. You can help support the channel by buying it on my website. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button for more accounting tutorials. And if you found this one useful, then give it a like, leave a comment. Why not? See you soon.